Greetings everyone. Today we have with us Dr. Manan Rawal, who is currently spearheading Ramanbhai Patel College of Pharmacy, which is a part of Charusat University as a dean. He has a rich academic experience and has published many national and international papers in various journals. He's a PhD from MSU and his area of expertise lies in separation and isolation of bioactomoids from medicinal plants and phytochemical analysis. On behalf of College Dunya, I would like to thank Dr. Manan for giving us this opportunity to interview him and being a part of our College Dunya initiative, Thoughtful Leaders. On that note, I'd like to start with the first question, sir, which is, you know, you have held key positions at various educational institutes throughout your professional career. So what are the key factors that has kept you connected with the education sector in general?
First of all, I'm passionate about teaching, and that brought me here in the field of academics. Then the dynamism, the freedom what you receive in the field of academics, education, and most importantly, this is the noble field. This is the noblest field of working, and here you are the part of the team which can build the talent for the nation. So this sustained me here for a long time.
That's really wonderful to hear, sir. On that note, we'd like to move on to our next question, you know, which is, being the head of RPCP, how do you strategize about the key programs and, you know, plans for marketing and administration of your college in particular?
Well, I do come at marketing later on, but let's first talk about administration. At my institute and at the larger perspective at our university, Charusat University of Science and Technology, we do believe in collaborative working. So we also do believe in consultative decisions. So our decision makings are always consultative. We get to the feedbacks from our stakeholders. We continuously meet those stakeholders, employers, the students, the parents, university administration, and of course the faculty members. So we have very close meetings and close associations with them. We do discuss our policies, implications, executions, aspects, and ultimately putting everybody in the confidence, we do take some decision. And in this situation, yes, we are a little bit slower, but we are very firm on those aspects, and then in most of the cases we achieve the goals. When it comes to marketing, we usually don't go for active marketing. Rather, our students are our ambassadors actually. They do market for us indirectly. They do talk for our policies, what they received from the institute, our treatments towards the students, the opportunities they got at the institute while they were studying, they were students here, and then after, even the continuous support of the institute to the students in form of the alumni association, the opportunities we provide to our alumni as in development of those students as entrepreneurs, and those all will lead us to, in a way, very competitive manner. So honestly, we don't go with active marketing or active promotion. This is the only way we work like that.
So that's really great. You know, essentially, you people do not market, but, you know, considering what you have imbibed in the students, you know, and help the students reach a goal in their career, they themselves, you know, want to be proud of their alum base or the college that they are associated with, and they like to market it. That's really wonderful. I believe that not many colleges would be able to boast of that. On that note, we'd like to move on to our next question, which is, you know, what makes or breaks a student's career or a college is essentially the curriculum of the college. And, you know, what the student learns there, it is a reflection of the college and its curriculum. So, you know, how does the curriculum of RPCP ensure that the best practices of the industry are followed? And when students graduate from this college, they are industry ready to, you know, take on the next challenge in their career. And, you know, they are aware about all this and have the necessary skill sets for the industry.
Well, curriculum is actually the heart of any of the academic institution. We do extremely careful when we take the decisions on construction or the drafting the curriculum for the students. And again, as I told you, this is a consultative process. Again, we do have contacts in industries. We have a very close association with our alumni who are placed in very nice positions in different industries in allied sectors, not only in pharmacy. We do take responses from the parents that what they are feeling that the things are to be incorporated in the present curriculum, and ultimately with this all consultative decision, we have a curriculum development committee which is made up of the half of the members from the industry, half of the members from the staff member and other academic peers. We have consultative meetings. We do focus not only on the curriculum development, but we do focus on outcomes also. Because ultimately, one day, the graduate who is going to pass out from the institute is go to the society, and what our curriculum will go to the society in form of graduate capabilities. That we always think of, and then we propose the curriculum. Proposing curriculum is rather easier than implementing curriculum. So implementation has its own challenges, but this is the process what we follow usually in making the curriculum. Now, when it comes to the second part of your question, that is, how do we match with the industry norms or industry-based practices? So we do have a few of the components in our curriculum which will make the students closer to the industries. We have the training program where the students mandatory have to go to the industry for a few weeks. That is for undergraduate students. For postgraduate students, we have in their project component only, there is a component of 5 weeks training. So they can compulsorily go to the industry. They do work in the industry atmosphere, and in most of the cases, those industries propose them the job. Mm-hmm. Apart from that, we do receive nearly 10 to 12, more than those industry consultancy projects. So undergraduate and postgraduate students, they do work in close association with those industry. They do represent their outcomes, the experimental outcomes with the industry people, and they learned a lot there. So this is how we do imbibe the industry culture to the students. Mm-hmm. And when it comes to another part, that is industrial research, mm-hmm. We do have one specialized program for undergraduate students, that is a summer fellowship program. So we offer that summer fellowship program that is based on a smaller industrial or industry linked project where they do learn the few of the intricacies of the pharmaceutical projects which usually we receive from the industries, the problems, and they try to solve these out within the period of I think so 4 weeks or 3 weeks in summer vacation. So this is all about our approaches to make the students busy considering the industry demands and all.
Wonderful, sir. So that's really great. On that note, let's move on to our next question, which is, you know, we are all aware about Charles Sutt University. It has made a mark for itself in Gujarat and, you know, even pan-India now. So what do you think should be Charles Sutt University's top priority for over the next year? And also, what should be RPCP's next priority over the next 10 years. So if you could, you know, elaborate on both of those things.
New education policy has come into the picture now. It has been officially declared. And the emphasis is on make the student to think. Mm-hmm. That is the fundamental concept of new education policy. There are other things also, but this is one of the crux of the education policies. So we do stress upon the innovation. We try to make our students much more aware about the opportunities of innovation and the protecting their intellectual property. These two are very core component of pharmaceutical business. Then apart from that, we make them realize about the value and ethics. And apart from that, what they can do for the society. So societal responsibilities are the major component of our curriculum. we are very firm believer that the graduates of the Charulzet and of Raman Bhai Patel College of Pharmacy must give back something to the society. So this is something which we would like to achieve in next 10 years, that our graduate must come up with the innovative ideas. We may have the patents which has earned from the graduates, and a graduate substantially support the society with their work, with their monetary grants or anything. But this is something we are working upon. We have our objective planning, and I'm glad to share that our plannings are going very well these days. Let's see what will happen in next 10 years.
That's really wonderful, sir. And I hope, you know, whatever goals that you set in mind for the university and for our RPCP in particular, you are able to achieve that and, you know, take the college to greater heights. On that note, we'd like to move on to our next question, which is, you know, students nowadays, you know, we have Gen Z. They're always searching for information. They're trying to understand what a college offers and, you know, how is it better than the peer college, or, you know, what they might gain out of one college instead of going to some other college. So, you know, what is that one thing that would like the aspiring students of Raman Bhai Patel College of Pharmacy that they may not be knowing, and, you know, how it makes it stand apart from other pharmacy colleges in general?
Well, this is a word, university. We do believe that we are different from the school education. We don't just make the graduates who are industry ready. There are so many institutions, those can be able to produce the graduates, those are industry ready. But rather, we focus on producing the graduates which are capable of taking the real life challenges. Because it is not just the industry or just not the profession. It is all about the life. So we would like to produce the graduates who can be able to take real life challenges, who can come forward, have the leadership qualities and all. And that is something that our students prove. A few of our students have cracked IAS examination, few of our students have cracked GPSC. So it is not just about the pharmaceutical industry or getting a job in industry, R&D, F&D. That is a common component for our students now. We are aiming something very big, and this makes us to our institute differ from others.
That's really wonderful. So I am definitely sure not many colleges can boast about such a great alum base, where, you know, the students are a part of prestigious institutes. So on that note, we'd like to move on to our last question of the interview, and that is, you know, given the current situation, there's a lot of confusion in the students' minds, and, you know, they are also trying to understand what should be the next steps. So any suggestions that you'd like to give the current youth and aspiring students to, you know, help them guide in the right direction?
Well, I have been in this field since 15, 17 years, and as a tradition of our university, we have all been in a consultative procedure of taking the decision. So I have seen the situation very closely, especially training placement component. And well, I realize I have seen many of the students progressed very well. So I realized one thing, that this world is not just made up of one profession. And something where you are graduated, that does not mean that you are destined to go in that discipline only. There are n number of approaches here. So if somebody in pharmacy, does not mean that he or she necessarily would like to go, or he has to go, she has to go in only in pharmaceutical industry. There are n number of light industry, there are n number of other service sectors which are related to pharmaceutical or chemical industries. There are n number of opportunities available in entrepreneurship. Student should explore those two. So instead of being ultimately a job seeker, students or graduates would like to have a dream in their life that one day they will be job giver. This
that's really
like
what
to mention here.
Wonderful, so wonderful. I believe that's a really good thought, that, you know, instead of just being in seeking jobs, become a job creator and make a career for yourself and also for others in that way. On that note, I would like to end the interview and really thank you for giving us your precious time and, you know, giving us the opportunity to interact with you. Thank you so for your time.
Thank you. Thank you, Ishita.